Hello all, welcome to Athrill Studio, and today we are going to create a beautiful picture of Radha Krishna. Now when we start our Madhubani paintings, we see that they have beautiful borders, and I'm creating one double border wherein I have put in two small borders together. I am using waterproof ink and the G nib for drawing my design. Now this double border gives a very beautiful frame, because what I have chosen for my painting is an A3 size painting. So it is a big one. So a broader border will look very nice. So here I'm filling the background with the lines, which is a form of Kachni lines, and a solid plain border. I have made my drawings, basically designed it with pencil, so that there is room for improvisation and any other idea that may come on the way. So once I have the picture in mind, I will start the inking my painting. So this is the Krishna's face, and I'm making details which are not made by the pencil. So directly the details, the basic line format I have made. But you are not supposed to make all the details, just a basic rough sketch, and thereon you will have the idea, and you may not have to trace it. I do not trace the design, but that gives me a guideline of how to I go forward. So this is the cloth that is tied on the head, since he was a shepherd and has always a peacock feather on his head. So this is the peacock feather. Madhubani has, all the characters we see have very beautiful and big eyes, and they look like a fish. So this is the type of the eye. It's relatively big. And we go ahead with making the design on the cloth that is tied on the head. My personal take on the picture is always that I do not outline the features of the face and body with double line. I only outline the clothing, the accessory and other things, but not the outline of the face. You may or may not, that's your personal choice. So here Madhubani paintings are known for very high detailing and very thin work. So here I am creating the upper body with all the details. Those who are not comfortable with the ink and the nib can go for a waterproof pen. Waterproof pen, because once you decide to paint later, then the color will be stable and it will not flow and spoil the other colors. So when we do a small drawing with the pencil, we get the idea of what is going over and what is going under. So the layering of the figure gets very easy if it's not a very blank figure. So for intricate figures or a high and complex figures, it's advised to do a little bit of drawing also. I'm doing the lower part of the body and the cloth that is called the dhoti. The upper torso or the upper part of the body is bare, and we will do the light blue color for his body. These are the small ornaments that even males used to wear. So these embellishments are totally your take on it, how much elaborate you want it to be. This is a very big piece, and I am just making it a little more detailed. So the prints on the cloth and the accessory is totally your wish, how heavy or light you want it to be. Heavy borders and very small motifs in the dress always look very beautiful. This is the picture that I am doing in the Bharni style. Bharni, as I say, it is full of color. We will be coloring it. And whereas there is a very famous form which is Kachni, which only has the lines. If we want little color in the Kachni, then it is colorful lines. But we do not do a lot of coloring in that. If you want your picture to be bold, bright and beautiful, then you can go for Bharni. Now, Bharni in the olden days was mostly practiced by the Brahmins, where generally the gods and the goddesses were made. We see that they were done in Bharni style mostly, though it doesn't follow as it is not followed as a rule now, but mostly it is seen like this. So when we make the figure of the male and the female, we just always keep in mind that the height, the proportions, the tenderness of the body will be different between males and females, which I will discuss as a comparative study when I will be doing the Radha also. If you're liking my video, do not forget to subscribe. And I also want to thank all those who have subscribed and supported me so far. Thanks for all your support. But the ones who are new must hit on a subscribe and press the bell icon so that you do not miss any of my further videos. There is also a tutorial, a full length tutorial, 10-day tutorial on my channel. Those who want to learn Madhubani painting from scratch, from basic to advanced, can have a look at that also. So it's a step by step day wise tutorial which is posted. Now we'll start with Radha and we'll see how tender the features are. We'll see that the nose will be softer, the chin will be softer, the lips will be smiling and the eyes will be big. So this is sometimes when we see the Madhubani paintings, we see that they are very, very big and every artist has their own take on it. I want it to be this way. I hope you like this. So this is the cover of the head. I want a little curled hair and this is the way I do it. Long open hair and a small crown like thing, maybe tiara or something. Those are the hair accessories. Anyone can choose their own style. Double outlining all the accessories. As I said, I won't be double outlining it for the face and the features, the hand and the body, but I always do it for the other elements. Generally, we see the ear. The accessories are big and beautiful. Even when we are doing the motifs like fish, tree, animals, we always accessorize them and make them beautiful with painting them with motifs and flowers and other accessories. So when it comes to the figures, we do a little more and do accessorization. So here I'll be layering the jewelry into many bands of necklaces and a flower garland also. How do we make faces in the Madhubani painting also is dealt in one of my tutorials. You may have a look at it. If there are any suggestions or any doubts, you can write it to me on the comment box and I will be very, very happy to help you out. Any other form of Madhubani painting or any other subject that you want me to do and do the tutorial on, do write to me and I will take it really seriously. So here when we do both male and the female, we see that there is a height factor also. The male is big, the Krishna is big, more broad in the body, the shoulders are broad, the physique is more manly, whereas for the Radha, she is tender and she is very feminine and the eyes are more flowy, lips are more full and lots of accessory. And the dress will also be very heavily detailed. So dressing her up in a lehenga and a blouse and with the dupatta. So we'll go ahead with all the design. I'm making small tassels or beads hanging. This all create beautiful effects in the painting. If you just eliminate this, it will go a little non-detailed and blank. The more you do these exercises, they give you the thought of designing your picture altogether, being creative and making your own designs. So the hair, and I will be just doing a small lace on the dupatta. This looks very, very beautiful. It gives a very beautiful edge. So whenever you're doing a female figure, if you add this, it will be really good. So this is the dupatta from the other side. And the same lace gets continued. Now this is the hair that we got after we make the dupatta. We get the space of how much space we have and then we do the hair. So that is when your pencil lining or your pencil drawing comes handy, when you know that how much spacing and everything is done. So just there's no harm to do a little bit of pencil sketch also if you are designing your picture on your own. If you are inspired by anybody, Google, Pinterest or anybody, then you can just start copying. But if in case you want to design your own picture, start with the pencil. So going on all the details, add borders, motifs, flowers in the hair, beads in the hair. These are the main things how you will just not do just black hair, which for the males we do black hair, but for the ladies' hair we just put them with beads, flowers and other accessories, which I think this Radha is really, really has heavy detailing on the hair. Now all the dress that I make, I will be making it with small motifs because already the picture will be very, very heavy. I'm always fond of these little flowers and I make these in my pictures. You can change the motif as per your desire. Do follow my Facebook page also. I will be announcing all the free workshops. I do all the free workshops on Saturdays and Sundays, on which are live on YouTube. So those who have not subscribed, do subscribe and join me every Saturday, Sunday for a free tutorial on any of the art forms. So we have done Varli, Sora, and they are full-fledged, where you can learn about the history, about their origin and main features of the art. So dividing the panels of the lehenga, and now detailing one in a form which will be repeated in all the panels. Now here I am creating the double outline which will differentiate between the background and the motif. You can make any design that you wish to make, especially in the dresses, in the ornaments, hairstyle, flower on the hair, anything can be changed. I generally, when I make the eyes, I make the upper lash line very heavy to create the lash kind of a look, and the eye looks really, really beautiful. Now going on to the background, I will be creating a garden around, and this is the tree with flowers. Since everything is too heavy, I'll keep the background a little light with simple flowers. So these are big flowers, and I'll just simply color it with any bold color. Now this is the ground. This is a typical way of making the ground that we see in Madhubani. So a small line that is differentiating between the ground and the background. On the other side, I'll be making a bird. Birds, trees, these things are very, very commonly seen. Generally, we make the main subject, whatever the main element is, in the middle of the painting, and then we fill up all the space with flowers and leaves. And Madhubani paintings are very highly decorated, and generally we see that very less or no place is left. So here I made my whole bird, because now then I will be putting in the branch and the leaves. So this is my branch here. You can go freehand with this, you do not really need to sketch it out, because this is more fluid and you can go any which way you like to make your flowers and the leaves. Here a small variation in the flower, the leaves get pointed. You can make any flower that you want to. They are small or big. I'm just making the tree bushes and few flowers on the ground. Now what I'm using here is the acrylic paint and a synthetic round brush to color my picture. When you color your picture, it is very important to think first whether you want to keep your background what color. So if you plan to do your backgrounds in dark color, you have to keep something light. So here flowers, I'm doing dark red and dark yellow, so they will stand out in green background. For the body, I have created a shade of blue, which is light blue, and I mixed white in it. Try to spread it smoothly and not it shouldn't give you much of the patches. So while you fill the color, you have to rub it till you are satisfied with your strokes. If you do not have acrylic paints, you can always go for poster color. Poster colors are a little chalky and they work fine. You have to just make sure that you have made your picture with a waterproof ink or waterproof pen. Otherwise, it will get spoiled. Once you touch the water, all the black will get spread. Now here I've taken a little dark blue to give a depth, and I'm doing the outline in the areas where I want more depth. So this will create a very warm effect in the face. So this is a very small face. But here I have done one painting which is an A3 size with only one big face, wherein you will get to know where to use which shade and how to give it a beautiful effect. This is a bride painting. For those who have not seen, can have a look at it. You can fill your border with desired colors, but you always have to keep in mind what colors are coming just right beside it. So generally the colors used in Madhubani will be really, really bright and they will stand out. So these are known for bright colors. So any pastel shades or any subtle colors, even if you want to do it, you have to contrast it with a bright or a very dark color. So generally when you see, you will see yellow, red, green, maroon, orange, black. These will be the contrasts that are used very frequently and they look very beautiful. Purple and orange is amazing. Light blue and purple. So different combinations you will get to know when you will start practicing. For this face of Radha, I have mixed a lot of white in the flesh tint color. If you do not have flesh tint color, you can easily make it keeping the white color as the base and adding little bit of brown, orange and yellow, and you will get this shade. I advise you, when you are making a shade, make it enough so that you can cover the whole area with that. You do not have to do it in small batches, because if you do it, you might end up in making different shades of it. So you can just make one enough quantity to fill in the areas. Like I did a little bit of shading on the face of Krishna, I did the same for Radha, creating a little brown effects. Now contrasting all the dress, balancing of the painting is very important when you choose to do the painting on your own. So you have to see that not most of the reds and the pinks and the purples are in one corner, so your picture has to be balanced. If you have used yellow in one corner, then it has to balance on the other side. That gives a very pleasing effect to the eye. If it is all dark shades for one figure and all light shades and bright shades for one, it'll look very odd or may not be looking very pleasant. So you have to really think about the colors, about the theory of the colors, what goes well with what, and you also have to keep in mind in your whole painting, which area is going more heavy or which area is going more light. Here I'm alternating it, and I didn't like the yellow color, so I just changed it to this because my yellow was going very close to this ground shade, the shade that I colored the ground, and it wasn't standing very well, and so I replicated and just changed in the inside panel. Now I'm choosing the colors which are standing out, greens and pinks, and the blouse in dark blue. While you are painting a picture, always think about the background also. Do not neglect it, because sometimes we make the painting so beautiful and we do not have any idea about what color to choose for the background. So background, you have to keep in mind whether you want to make it a sunset sky or night or which time of the day your sky will be. You can also go according to your wish and take any other color which is not really the color. You can just choose any color, gray or blue or whatever, and do the background. Now here for these small dots, I'm just taking a dotting tool and creating the dots to get it more rounded and beautiful. So you can keep on experiment with different tools, and whatever suits best, pick that. Going back to the tree, I'll keep this side of it light, and then I'm taking my pen and waterproof ink and doing the drawing over it. So I'm making small leaves which will give me the effect of a little dark and dense tree. This really overlaying work looks very beautiful. You must give it a try. Taking out few branches and leaves to give it more natural look and fill up for the space that is left. Now I'm using the same color to give it a match to the tree. I hope you liked this video, and this is how my painting looks like. I hope you all liked the video. Thanks for watching.